All right, well, let's take a quick look at our bulletins this morning.
我们一起来看周报的消息。
CIBC Choir will have practice this afternoon at 1 o'clock. If you are a member of CIBC and you're interested in attending choir, please contact Teacher Viola. And now, as you know, the choir is starting to practice for Christmas Eve service. So please be praying for our choir and pray for the Christmas Eve service.
教会的诗班在聚会结束后一点要开始练唱。那他们现在练习的重点除了这个特殊的敬拜之外，最主要就是在圣诞夜还有圣诞节。那请大家为着诗班来献上祷告，特别如果有男生你是贝斯的，如果有这方面的负担，欢迎你一起来加入诗班的练习。And
then Calvary will have a Thanksgiving lunch right after the service today, Sunday service, right after the service, we're going to have a yummy turkey and all the trimmings lunch downstairs. I encourage everyone to stay. There's a lot of food, and it's just a good time to fellowship and get to know each other. So please stay after the service downstairs. We're going to have a wonderful Thanksgiving lunch.
今天我们教会结束以后会有感恩节的聚餐。 Five turkey?
Five turkeys.
所以东西是足够的，然后有很多的这些主餐跟甜点，那邀请弟兄姐妹留步一起来交易认识。
And also today, after we're going to have our Calvary Christmas tree and Christmas decorating. So after lunch, if you can stay, we would appreciate your help. We're going to set up the Christmas tree and decorate the church for Christmas.
那感恩节聚餐之后，也邀请弟兄姐妹，如果你时间许可的话，一起来装饰教会的这些圣诞的装饰。我们会设立那个圣诞树，那如果你有时间，特别小朋友，邀请你一起来装饰我们的圣诞树。We
need some strong men to help with the Christmas tree.
Men after you ate，你吃了之后不要是打瞌睡哈。
And Calvary is going to be having their semi-annual general business meeting to vote on the 2025 Calvary ministry plan on December 8th. Pastor John will be giving the preview today. If you are a Calvary International Baptist Church member, please join us right after church service on December 8th. The only item on the agenda will be to vote on the 2025 Calvary Ministry Plan. So next Sunday, there will be hard copies of the 2025 Ministry Plan for Calvary members to sign out and to review. If there are any questions, please contact Treasurer Jen and or Pastor John by email. And the email is on your bulletin. And please do so by December 6th.
教会的这个明年度的这个施工计划跟牧师意向的分享会在12月8号进行，就是12月的第二个礼拜。然后牧师今天也会来做一个PowerPoint的这个介绍。然后下个礼拜呢，我会把这个报告的内容印出来。 然后，如果你是我们教会的成员的话，欢迎你签名之后把这个东西带回家去参与。然后，在隔一个礼拜以后，12月8号，我们就要针对这个事项来投票。那12月8号，我们就有这个事项，你同意或不同意来进行投票。那如果你有任何的问题，我们牧师跟我们的严军执事的这个 email 就在这个地方，你可以用书面的方式 email 给牧师。 比如说，牧师啊，你应该加薪啦，也可以把它写上去。OK， 那这可以有一个 email 可以搭上，但是要在12月6号之前，把它 email 出去。And
we have some save the dates. Calvary will have its Calvary Christmas Ladies Fellowship on Saturday, December 7th at 11 o'clock downstairs in the fellowship hall. And I'm encouraging the ladies, invite a friend. And if you're coming to the Christmas Ladies Fellowship, please bring a wrapped coffee mug or a teacup for our gift exchange. Do not put your name on the gift. It's anonymous. Just bring a wrapped coffee mug or teacup to the Christmas Ladies Fellowship.
教会在十二月七号，有姐妹的聚会。那这个姐妹的聚会里面的话，有个特别的一个安排，就是让这些参与的姐妹们，你带一个包装好的马克杯或者是茶杯哈，那上面不要写名字啊，包装好的马克杯或者是茶杯，可能要做礼物交换或怎么样。那欢迎姐妹们也可以当天邀请你的福音朋友。
And then we have Christmas Sunday service that will be on Sunday, December 22nd at 11. And there'll be a Christmas lunch in the fellowship hall right after the service. I encourage you to come be praying about our Christmas service and invite a friend.
12月20号是我们的圣诞节的欢庆聚会哈。 然后聚会结束后，我们会有那个简单的一个午餐，那可以邀请朋友们或是家人们一起来参加12月22号的圣诞聚会。And
we also have a Calvary Christmas Candlelight Eve service. This is going to be on Tuesday, December 24th at 7 p.m. Please bring a friend and be praying over our Christmas Eve service, and we. Yeah,
just come celebrate Christmas. Sorry. 12月22号，礼拜晚上7点钟，我们有年度的圣诞的烛光晚会。那我们除了有特别的献诗，也会邀请一些特别的团体来这边演出。那这是一个传福音的非常好的一个机会。那如果你有未信主的家人，或是你在职场里面有这些。 你的好朋友他还没有相信耶稣的，都可以在12月24号礼拜晚上7点钟邀请他来参加我们的圣诞烛光聚会。
And please pray for the nation of the week as Turkmenistan. The government imposes tight restrictions and close surveillance on Christians. Religious activities are closely monitored. Printing or importing of Christian materials is restricted. Please pray for Turkmenistan, for the believer there, for the unbeliever. Continue to pray for the Middle East and always pray for Taiwan.
这个礼拜我们要祷告的国度是中亚的国家土库曼，回教的人口是占了93%，当中当然也有我们这些弟兄姐妹在当中。那如果你要传教或是印一些有关基督教的这些文宣的话，都受到非常大的一个压迫。 那请大家为土库曼的弟兄姐妹，为他们的当地的宣教来祷告，当然也为着我们以哈的战士、中东的战士、乌俄战争，还特别为着我们所爱的台湾来献上祷告。And
please join the Calvary Wednesday night verse by verse, chapter by chapter Bible study on YouTube. Pastor John will be teaching from Isaiah 46 to 47 this week. And again, this is a wonderful way to get to know your Bibles from Genesis to Revelation. If you need the QR code, it is in the front of your bulletin. I encourage you to click on that, like and subscribe.
每个礼拜三晚上，我们有线上的英语查经。那牧师目前的进度是以赛亚书的46章到47章。那牧师娘特别说，我们这个周报上有这个 QR code， 你可以扫描，那个是方便你随时可以来上线来学习。那牧师会用比较缓慢的速度来教导。 所以这是一个学习英文的一个很好的一个机会。And
we have for offering and tithes, you can take a look at your bulletin. You can take a look up here at the screen. We have our box in front of the church. You may drop off your tithe and offering before after the service.
我们的奉献每元台币都可以看到我们周报上面这些讯息。那我们的奉献箱就在门口。聚会前聚会结束，可以把奉献放进去。
And this morning, Anshin will give us the prayer for his tithe and offering.
我们邀请安顺做十一奉献的祷告。
Taiwan, and to spread your gospel, Father God. Thank you. use this portion, Father God, in tithes and offering for the mission in India, in Indonesia, and also some local churches in Philippines. Lord, we are grateful to have you. Give you all the praise and the peace, the joy, Father God, that you have given us, Father God. All this pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Stand in worship.
Thank you. pretty good. Everyone sing it to it and they're okay.
Thank you.
Next slide, please. You know, Calvary International Baptist Church centers around God's revelation to us, the Bible, through the teaching of His Word. We learn about His character plan and His love for us. And then you can read the following. It's just we grow in understanding of Him through the leading of the Holy Spirit.
那各个他教会到底是谁呢? Next slide, please. 各个他心学是以上帝对我们的启示圣经为中心的，通过他话语教导，我们了解他的性质、计划和他对我们的爱。那这是我们自己的这个信仰的一个告白。
And then next slide, please. You know, our Calvary ministry anchors, and this never changes, is to love God first, to love one another, to love the nation, and share the gospel.
那我们教会宣教的这个 定锚就是我们的目标是什么？就是定在爱神，彼此相爱，爱万国万民，跟分享福音上面。
Next slide, please. And then our 2025 CIBC ministry focus will be listening to what's around us, listening to the cries for help, praying about it, and as the Lord leads, helping and sharing.
我们2025年的这个宣教的重点。 就是聆听周遭的这些呼喊的声音，求救的声音，然后呢，为这些在呼喊者、在求救的人，我们来献上祷告。
Next slide, please. And we know these verses is basically love the Lord first,
And then love your neighbors. 马太福音二十二章的三十七到三十九节是我们非常了解的这个经文哈，就是神对爱的这个大的诫命。
And the next slide, please. We are supposed to make disciples and go to all the nations.
然后马太福音二十八章，这里就是大使命，神要我们去到万国万民，使他们受洗成为门徒。
And then next slide, please. We're going to receive power from the Holy Spirit, and we all know this. We should be witnesses here in Yangmingshan, in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Taipei, Samaria, Taiwan, and the furthest part of the earth.
然后《使徒行传》的一章八节，就是圣灵降临的时候，赋予我们能力，使我们能够在这个地方，就是阳明山，我们哥哥他进行了，就是我们耶路撒冷，然后台北就是我们犹太圈地，到撒玛利亚、台湾，到地极万国万民。
Next slide, please. So our 2025 goals, we continue to teach God's word, including the 22. Well, it's more than 22 weeks. It was supposed to be 22 weeks, but we continue to teach Revelation Sunday afternoons.Then provide discipleship opportunities, worship training opportunities, continue to support God's kingdom work, and then engage in mission opportunities, and then church-wide evangelism opportunities.
所以我们2025年的目标也是依据我们现在正在进行的啊，我们启示录的查经原本预定是22周，那现在虽然超过时间也没有关系，我继续在进行。然后提供这门徒训练机会，支持神国度的工作，然后参与宣教机会，然后提供全教会传福音的机会。
So next slide, please. So we continue to teach God's word. God's word is the foundation of this church. Sunday mornings we have 10 a.m. Bible studies in English and Chinese. We have Sunday morning service. We have Wednesday night Bible study that goes from Genesis to Revelation.Verse by verse, chapter by chapter. We have Sunday afternoon Bible studies, and then we have our Saturday servant leader update in prayer. That's once a month, and then Saturdays we have the parsonage Bible study. It's been going on for 2 years. We're going to make it official here at the church.
然后2025年的目标啊，我们的教会是建基在神的话语的上面，所以我们会继续教导神的话语。所以我们礼拜天有中英文的查经。然后主日早上，牧师在讲台上的教导，然后礼拜三晚上的线上查经是一章一章、一节一节的，按照圣经从创世纪到启示录进度在进行的。然后主日后我们就是有那个启示录目前在进行的第一个礼拜、第三个礼拜的查经。然后星期六呢，我们有每个月一次的这个更新祷告会。然后最后一点，这个周六牧师馆的圣经研习已经进行了两年了，所以牧师这次让他更正式的向弟兄姐妹发出邀请，有兴趣的话一起来参加。
So next slide, please. So 2025, the church already provides a lot of this already. We're going to do discipleship training, worship training, and then one day marriage seminars for different days, and then one day Christian single seminar. I'm going to talk more about that.We already have ladies fellowship, men's fellowship. We're praying for youth fellowship. So the Lord, we're praying for more youth to come, and then we already have the marriage fellowship.
2025年的目标一样接续我们往年在做的，所以我们教会就提供很多各团契的这样参与的机会，门徒训练、敬拜训练。然后牧师会针对一日的婚姻研讨会跟一日的单身基督徒的研讨会再进一步的说明。然后原本就有了姐妹弟兄青年团契，青年团契的话就是13岁以上的，然后我们再为这个事情再祷告。然后还有婚姻团契。
Next slide, please. The marriage seminar, I've been doing this for a couple decades now. It's a Becoming Friends Again series. It's always getting updated. And basically, once you get married, you know, we want people to make sure they're married toThey have a really good friendship. So you're becoming friends again. Recapturing friendship, becoming better friends, cultivating friendship and becoming best friends, treasuring friendship.
牧师做婚姻跟婚前的辅导已经有三十几年的时间，所以他的婚姻辅导的系列不断内容不断的在更新，然后再度成为朋友系列总共分了三个阶段，成为朋友就是重新获得友谊，成为更好的朋友就挖掘这个友谊的进行。然后最佳的朋友，这真是我们的友谊现有的，然后大家更我们更重视，更来持续。
So next slide, please. Christian single seminar. I've been listening a lot last few years from different churches and different places. There's a lot of single Christians here in Taiwan. So we're going to come up with a new series called Walking in Contentment Series. It's biblical answers for Christian singles about loneliness, depression, anger, anticipation, and then potential marriage. And then single Christians walking in love with Jesus, single Christians walking in hope with Jesus, single Christians walking in faith with Jesus.
牧师回来台湾以后就发觉说各地各教会都有很多这些单身的这些主内的弟兄姐妹，所以他在满足同行系列里面将要来做这样的一个单身基督徒的辅导，针对期末沮丧愤怒期待婚姻，要进入婚姻，来进行这个圣经的原则跟提供圣经的一些解答，所以有三个项目就会与耶稣的爱同行，与耶稣的盼望同行，与耶稣的信心同行。
Next slide, please. So for our church, we already support most of this for a few years now. Calvary, the CIBC, this church, this little church supports, helps support Calvary Baptist Convention, Chinese Baptist Convention, Taiwan Baptist Theological Seminary, Taiwan Theological Seminary across the street, Adonai Theological School in Indonesia, Huayu. Huayu Missions is huge. It's preparing Taiwanese to be missionaries to the closed countries of the world. And we're talking about the closed country in the Middle East and all that. So, and then Lintou Campgrounds next door here, Real Way Baptist Church in Cambodia, House of Grace Philippines. And then we're helping out Calvary Manila and 70 Calvary churches in the Philippines, India Missions with Pastor David and Jody. Jody is going back next Sunday, to train young people to be in the foundations. And then we're working with 6 Aboriginal churches in Southern Taiwan, working with IMB missionary Susan over there, one orphanage in Southern Taiwan.
2020年目标，其实我们就过去几年一直在持续的在进行，而且持续的在做连结，所以这是上帝的国度的工作。 然后我们针对华人进信会，我们这个台湾的进信会的神学院，那台湾神学院就在我们对面，然后阿东南的神学院是在印尼，然后华语才会是一个特别的台湾，是全球性的这个福音的宣教时空，是训练台湾人成为宣教士，到那个封闭的国家里面去传福音。我们叫做封闭的国家，可能就是那些回教的国家或者中东的国家，这些不对基督徒开放的这些国家。 那里头山庄也在我们教会附近，然后普世宣教是在柬埔寨、菲律宾的恩典之家，然后在菲律宾我有马尼拉的哥哥他进信会跟70个哥哥他的这些伙伴的教会，然后印度的宣教师工是大会跟菲加利牧师，菲加利牧师下个礼拜就要在全区印度，然后训练当地，让他们学习圣经，然后建立他们的基础，成为宣教师。
So next slide, please. So for our church, we want to engage in mission opportunities, and these are the, as the Lord leads, we're looking to these for 2025, and how the Lord leads, we'll find out.
2025年我们就是有这些国度的宣教的机会，让弟兄姐妹能够了解，然后来支持、关心、奉献。
And then next slide, please. So January to June calendar of 2025. Actually, Pastor David is going to help give a seminar on the heart of worship. And we're going to invite all the worship team and anyone who's interested to come. That's in January. And then Chinese Lunar New Year's, we're going to, that's coming up. And then the Christian Singles Seminar in February. And of course, we have our semi-annual church business meeting January to March. Then again, Christian Single Week Seminar in April. Then discipleship training from February to May. That's gonna be online, and we're gonna talk more about that as it gets closer. We have Good Friday, and all the way through May, we have a marriage seminar in May, and then short-term missions in June.
所以明年上半年度第一个1月份的时候，我们就有大会牧师 他会带领这些对敬拜有兴趣的这些弟兄姐妹一起来研习，怎么样从心里来认识神，然后把神当作我们唯一敬拜的对象。然后各个的行事历，那大家可以看到，你有看到我们在2月份有2月份，然后4月份都有这个单身的辅导研习。 然后五月份有婚姻的辅导营习。
And then July to next slide, July through December, we have in short-term missions, July to August, Christian single seminar, the third one in September. Then we have a Calvary Chapel Asia conference in September. A bunch of people wanted to sign up already. Marriage seminar in October. Then the Calvary, the Chinese Baptist convention in October. Semi-annual business meeting October, between October and December. And then Christmas community outreach and Christmas Eve, December 24th.
然后明年下半年度的行事历我们也列出来了。那单身基督徒辅导有一次在九月份，然后婚姻辅导十月份，然后这些十二月就有圣诞节的外展活动。
So next slide, please. So January through October 2024 ministry at a glance. We are very transparent here at Calvary. Every penny that comes in, every dollar that comes in, it goes to one of these three: is love God, love one another, serve the nation, and then all these other administration total. Everything is accounted for. So we're very transparent here. Go ahead.
我们教会的这是今年的一月到十月嘛，因为我们现在是十一月份，所以排到还有两个月的时间还要再结算。那教会的财务的状况，奉献的这些收入都是其实非常非常的透明，然后都可以接受检验的。所以弟兄姐妹如果有任何的问题，都可以向监丁或是牧师来询问。
And then the next slide, please. The financial ministry support. You know, we have a budget, and then we have January to October, and then we have a estimated in at the end of the year, and then we have a proposed 2025. This will all be printed out.Next Sunday, so if you're a member, you can sign this up.
下礼拜天我们都会把这些财务的状况啊详列出来，然后弟兄姐妹都可以签名来领取。然后我们看到我们到一到十月份啊第二个项目，然后估计到年底的这些项目，以及我们明年度2025年我们提供的这预算的这个预期。
Next slide, please. And last slide. This is basically our 2025 proposed. We have the 2024 budget.Then we have the estimated, and then we have the proposed for 2025. What we did was we add 5% to all the expenses based on inflation to cover it. And then this church actually gives minimum of 10% of anything that comes in to missions. Actually, we do a lot more, and we'll find out as the Lord leads.
然后大家可以看到是所有的这些整个的收支哈，2024年第一个项目是预算，然后到年底啊，2024年年底啊会有多少钱？然后2025年我们做了一个预期的这些项目，然后大家可以看到有一个 percent 的这个通货膨胀的调整，然后下面有一个跟这这些对外宣教教会所有的奉献的收入的十分之一，我们都做这些宣教的奉献，然后还有这个我们有一个爱人如己的这个。5% 的这样的一个奉献。
So that's the preview, and then we're going to have a meeting in two Sundays. Let's stand for the scripture reading, and I'm going to get Alchan to lead us in English, and Monica will lead us in Chinese.
欢迎大家十二月八号留步参加教会的这些行政的会议。
Concerning the children of Israel, saying, This is the thing which the Lord has commanded. If a man makes a vow to the Lord, or swears not to bind himself by some agreement, he shall not break his word, he shall not do according to all that proceeds out of his mouth. Hebrews 7:25. Therefore, he is also able to save to the uttermost.Those who come to God through him, since he is always lives to make intercession for them.
民数记三十章一到二节，摩西对以色列各支派的领袖说：“这是耶和华所吩咐的话。人若向耶和华许愿或起誓，要约束自己，就不可食言。”必须照口中所出的一切话去做。希伯来书7:25，所以凡靠着他进到神面前的人，他都能拯救到底， 因为他长远活着为他们祈求。
All right, you may be seated, and Sunday school students are dismissed for Sunday school. So, good morning, everyone. You know, let's start with a prayer.
我们一起来祷告。
Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父
we again want to thank you for today.
我们的今天献上感谢
that we can come to church to worship you.
为什么能够实体来教会敬拜你献上感谢
I pray that your Holy Spirit will just open up our hearts.
主啊，求你的圣灵开启我们的心
Allow your word to come into our hearts, our minds, our soul.
让我们的身心灵被你的话语所喂养
We pray in the name of Jesus.
从耶稣基督的圣灵祷告
Amen. You know, I love Communion Sundays, and we also have Thanksgiving lunch today, and I can't wait.
今天是我们每个月第四个礼拜的圣餐主日，那我们待会还有感恩节的聚餐。
So happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
祝大家感恩节愉快。
You know, God is so good. You know, He provides everything for us. So my question for you today is, how do you define the verb?To trust.
神是何等的良善啊，提供我们每日这个所需。但是牧师要问大家一个问题：这个信任、信靠，你怎么样来界定
？How do you know that this person can be trusted?
你怎么知道这个人可以被信任呢
？You know, Merriam-Webster Dictionary defines trust as to rely on the truthfulness or the accuracy of, to place confidence in, and to hope or expect.Confidently,
韦氏大师典这样界定什么叫做信任，就是我们对这个人他的诚实，对他的信用，我们有信心，我们相信他所讲的是正确的，是可以被信任的。
But how do you really know that this person can be trusted?
但是你怎么知道这个人可以被信任呢
？I think one way is to know that if to check if this person keeps his word, keeps his promises or not.
我们可以看看这个人是不是真的就是从不食言，是不是他口中所话的所说的话，他会遵守到底。
We know that God Himself, God always kept His word throughout Israel's history and continues to do so.
我们知道神在以色列的历史当中，以及神在我们的生命的历程里面，神永远是那个不食言的那位。
Joshua 21:45 Not a word failed of any good things which the Lord had spoken to the house of Israel. All came to pass.
约书亚记的21:45耶和华应许赐福给以色列家的一句话都没有落空，都应验了。
Numbers 23:19 God is not man that he should lie, or a son of man that he should change his mind. Has he said, and will he not do it? Or has he spoken, and will he not fulfill it?
民数记的23:19神非人，必不至说谎，也非人子，也不至后悔。他说话岂不照着行呢？他发言岂不是要成就的
？You know, today we are in Numbers 30, and we just read that God does not want man to break his vows to the Lord and to break his vows to others.
今天我们的进度来到民数记的30，神不希望人的话落空。神希望人说话要遵照他所说的。
God is serious about promises, about keeping one's word.
神对承诺是非常非常看重，神对人所说的这些许愿的话、应许的话，希望他能够实现。
God keeps his word. What he says, he will do.
神绝不食言，他所说的必要成就。
If we believe in Jesus, the Son of God, He will give us eternal life.
如果我们相信耶稣就是神所派那个要救赎我们，我们就享有永生。
He expects man to keep his word when making a promise to God and making up an agreement with others.
神希望人对神所许愿，以及人跟人之间的这些应许承诺的话，都要实现。
You know, if a man says that, you know.I'm going to tithe. I'm going to give 10% of what I make to God. And he makes $100 and he gives $10. That's pretty easy.
所以如果有人许愿说我要向神奉献1/10，他赚了100块然后奉献10块钱，很简单吧。
What if he made $1,000 and then it's going to be $100, and that's a lot in US dollars.
若以美金一千元来讲的话，要奉献一百块美金呢，哎，可数字不小。
What if later he makes $100, $1 million, $10 million, $100 million?
如果他赚了十万美金、一百万美金、一千万美金、一亿美金，哎，十分之一可不少哎。
To give $10 million of my money to the church, are you crazy, Pastor?
你要我捐十万块美金给教会，牧师，你疯了吗？
I don't think I'm crazy, but maybe a little. I am crazy about my wife Susan.
我不认为啊，捐献那个十万美金其实很疯狂一件事。Crazy in love with Susan. 牧师对牧师娘是非常非常疯狂的爱她。
Do you still keep your promises to God?
这十分之一的奉献你要遵守吗？
Well, that's a lot of money, and I don't know if the church will know what to do with that type of money.
哎，十万块美金很多呢，教会知道怎么样来处理这十万块美金吗？
I just don't trust the deacons, the elders, the pastors with that type of money.
我才不相信这些长执、这牧师呢，他会忠心的来运用这些奉献的钱。
That's why I don't tithe, because I make a lot of money.
我才不十一奉献呢，因为我赚很多钱呢。
You know, there's some people that say that's why I don't keep my promises to God, because I'm protecting God from all these elders.
我才不做十一奉献呢，因为我怕这个长子没有好好运用这些奉献。哎，我在保护神呢。
I don't know if they know what to do.If the deacons, elders, and pastor even pray or not.
我才不信这些长子呢，长子在运用这些奉献的时候，到底有没有好好祷告啊？
When one says, I just don't know, so I'll just be keeping my money till when?
那我既然不把钱奉献进去，那我把这些钱要留到什么时候呢？
Till you die and meet God?
直到我们死了，然后去见神吗
？Leave everything to people who may not even know him.
把这些所有的钱都留给我甚至还不认识的人吗
？So God in the Bible wants us to give joyfully, wants us to give willingly to Him, never reluctantly.
所以神在奉献的教导上面是希望我们是一个甘心乐意奉献的人。
Because everything we have is from Him.
所以我们所有的这一切都是从神而来的。
If we are giving reluctantly, you know, the Bible, you know, if you read through the Bible, do not give.
如果我们给的心不甘情不愿，你看看圣经，圣经怎么教导的？宁可不要奉献。
God owns everything, including our very breath. We need to give willingly. And if you're giving to the church reluctantly, please.Do not give.
神是掌管一切的，包括我们的生命气息。如果你给的心不甘情不愿，不，千万不要奉献。
God does not need your money, and the church does not need your money if the church is following the Lord.
如果神不会要那些心不甘情不愿的，你心不甘情不愿奉献给教会，属神的教会也不会接受。
God does not force anyone to do anything.
神才不会强迫人去做任何事情。
Giving is always with a thankful heart, with a willing heart.
奉献是一个感恩的心情去做奉献。
CIBC gives a minimum of 10% of income of our income at the church to missions, and usually is even more.
我们的教会感谢神丰丰富的供应，所以我们10%会奉献在神国度的宣教上面。
As the tithe and offering flows in, we let it.Flow out into work with the missions of giving the gospel to the nations.
当奉献进来教会以后，我们会让它流出去，给神这些宣教的事工来运用。
You know, the church and this church understands that everything is owned by Him and comes from Him.
我知道属神的教会以及包括我们的教会都知道，所有的一切都是从神而来。
If CIBC is doing something that is pleasing to God.God will continue to watch over and bless CIBC.
如果教会照着神的心意去做的话，神就会继续的祝福，然后继续的供应教会。
If not, God will stop it.
如果没有照神的心意，神必然停止。
And I want to stop right here because we have someone not feeling well over there. I want to pray. Is that
Maseo?
I'm gonna pray for Pastor Maseo right now.
Heavenly Father,
we want to ask you to be with Pastor Maseo right now. He's not feeling well. May you just touch his body, Lord.
主啊, 求你医治他, 照顾他。
We know the ambulance is coming right now, and I pray, Lord, that you would touch him from the top of his head to the bottom of his toes.
我们知道救护车正在来的路上, 主啊, 你的手从头到脚, 抚慰, 照顾摩西牧师。
You are the great healer.
你是那个伟大的医治者。
You can heal, Lord.
你可以医治他。
So we pray for him.
奉耶稣基督的名来祝福他。
Touch him, Lord.
主啊，求你触摸他。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
All right. So as we continue, it's very, very weird to me that people can say that they trust God with salvation, with their eternity, to come to church to learn about God's plan, trust the church leadership with teaching God's word, but does not trust God's church with tithe and offering.
一个人如果自称说，我相信神的救赎，我相信那位赐永生给我的神，他自称他认识那位神，他也进到认识神的教会里面，他也相信说这个教会会按照神的计划去进行，但是他就不相信说，神的这些的教会的这些长子们，他会照神的心意来运用。They
only trust if it's $10, but not more.
他们想说，哎，我赚100块，奉献10块钱，可以。
It's very strange to not trust God to take care of His church.
他不相信说，哎，神会照顾他的教会。
If someone in leadership is doing something wrong with finances, do we not trust that God will see it and God will deal with it?
如果教会的这些管理者没有好好运用这些教会奉献的话， 神他难道看不到吗?
Again, everything is owned by God, including our very own breath.
我们的生命气息都在神的手中啊。
God is not fooled.
神是轻慢不得。
And He will not be mocked.
你知道我们的神是掌管一切，知道一切的。
God wants man to keep His word.
神要人实话实说。
By the way, anyone in church leadership will be more accountable to God. And God's word tells us that if they were doing something wrong, God will take them out one way or another in His timing.
你知道这个神教会的管理者或者属灵的领袖，如果有问题的话，神是一定会惩治他的。
So there was a married couple in the New Testament, and they had a piece of property.
在使徒行传记载的已婚夫妇，他们有一块田地。
They told the church that they would sell the property and give it all to God, to the apostles, to the church.
这对夫妇说，我会把这田地卖了，然后把所得的金钱全部奉献给教会。
But when they sold the property, they kept a portion to themselves and gave the rest to the church.
但是他们卖了田地以后，自己保留了一部分，然后把其余的奉献给教会。
I mean, this sounds okay, right? They gave something.
这听起来应该没有错，他们至少奉献了一部分嘛。
Acts 5:3-4, but Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and keep back part of the price of the land for yourself? While it remained, was it not your own? And as it was sold, was it not in your own control? Why have you conceived this thing in your heart? You have not lied to men, but to God.
使徒行传的5:3-4, 亚拿利亚，为什么撒旦充满你的心，叫你欺哄圣灵呢？把田地的价银私自留下几分呢？田地还没有卖，不是你自己的吗？既卖了，价银不是你做主吗？你怎么心里起这意念？你不是欺哄人，乃是欺哄神啊！They
could have just not made any promises to God about the property and kept it, and that was okay.
这对夫妇可以不做对神做任何奉献的承诺，然后把这卖的钱自己归自己，这没有问题的。They
could have just sold it and kept the money and do whatever they want with the money, and that was okay.
他们把田地卖了，然后钱他们想要怎么用都可以，这是没有问题的。But
they made a promise to give it all to God, to the apostles, to the church, and didn't keep their word.
他们呢，他们像教会、像使徒已经做了这样一个承诺，说田地卖了会把所有的钱奉献，但是他们没有。
What happened to Ananias?
那亚拿尼亚发生了什么事呢？
Acts 5:5. Then Ananias, hearing these words, fell down and breathed his last.
使徒行传的5:5，亚拿尼亚听见这话就扑倒了，断了气。
He died.
他死了。
What happened to his wife?
那他的妻子呢？
Acts 5:7-10. Now it was 3 hours later when his wife came in, not knowing what had happened. And Peter answered her, "Tell me whether you sold the land for so much." She said, "Yes, for so much." Then Peter said to her, "How is it that you have agreed together to test the Spirit of the Lord? Look, the feet of those who have buried your husband are at the door. They will carry you out." Then immediately she fell down at his feet and breathed her last. And the young men came in, found her dead, and carrying her out, buried her by her husband.
使徒行传的5:7-10，约过了3个小时，他的妻子进来，还不知道这事。彼得对他说：“你告诉我，你们卖田地的价银就是这些吗？”他说：“就是这些。”彼得说：“你们为什么同心试探主的灵呢？” 埋葬你丈夫之人的脚已到门口，他们也要把你抬出去。妇人立刻扑倒在彼得脚前，断了气。那些少年人进来，见他已经死了，就抬出去埋在他丈夫旁边。God
wants us to give joyfully, willingly, with a thankful heart, and not deceitfully, not reluctantly.
神要我们抱持一个感恩的心，然后做一个甘心乐意奉献的，不要欺哄神啊。
God wants man to keep his word to him and to others.
神希望人们对神所许的，你要照着行，然后对人所许的这些约、这承诺，也要照着实行。
But at the time in Numbers, something was very different for women.
但是在民数记，针对妇女的话，有些特别的规定。
Numbers 30:3-5. Or if a woman makes a vow to the Lord and binds herself by some agreement while in her father's house in her youth, and her father hears her vow and the agreement by which she has bound herself, and her father holds his peace, then all of her vows shall stand, and every agreement with which she has bound herself shall stand. But if her father overrules her on the day that he hears, then none of her vows nor her agreements by which she has bound herself shall stand, and the Lord will release her because her father overruled her.
民数记的30:3-5，女子年轻还在夫家的时候，若向耶和华许愿，要约束自己。她父亲听见她所许的愿和约束自己的话，却向她默默不言。她所许的愿和约束自己的话都有效。 但是若他父亲在听见的日子不允许他一切所许的愿和约束自己的话，这就不算为有效，耶和华也必赦免他，因为他父亲不允许。You
know, a man is to keep his word, but a woman, there's something different here in this section.
男人必须要遵照自己的话而行，要实践他的诺言，但女子在这边好像有不同的规定。So
a daughter living at home, making a vow, making a commitment that was not good for her. So on that very same day, if the father heard it and overruled it, then the vow becomes invalid.
所以一个女儿在家里面，她讲了一些许愿的话，或是一些承诺，然后她父亲听见说，哎，你不可以这样做了，说，所以父亲有权可以否认女儿所做的这些承诺。Then
if the daughter gets married, Numbers 36:6-8. If indeed she takes a husband, while bound by her vows or by a rash utterance from her lips by which she bound herself, then her husband hears it and make no response to her on the day that he hears, then her vows shall stand, and her agreements by which she bound herself shall stand. Verse 8, and if her husband overrules her on the same day and that he hears it, he shall make void her vow which she took and what she uttered with her lips, by which she bound herself, and the Lord will release her.
那如果这个女子已经出嫁的话呢，在民数记的30:6-8，她若已出嫁有怨在身，或口中出了约束自己的冒失话，她丈夫听见了，就在听见的日子向她默默不言，她所许愿、许的愿和约束自己的话就都有效。但是若她的丈夫在听见的日子不允许，丈夫就废了她自己许的愿和口中所出的约束自己的冒失话，耶和华也必赦免她。
You know, so if the wife, this is, gets interesting, is makes a vow, makes a promise, and by rash utterance of her lips, it's basically just saying talking way too much and made commitments because of rash utterances. If the husband heard it and overruled it that day, God will honor it.
如果一个已婚的妇人，她已经许了愿，或是因为讲了一些冒冒失失的话，轻易的那个承诺的话，那她丈夫如果听见的话，可以把她这所许的愿跟这些冒失的承诺给取消掉，然后神也必赦免这位女子。
His wife will be set free.
所以这丈夫的妻子所讲的冒失话被赦免。
But if the hubby did not do anything about it on that same day, then the promises will stand.
但是如果老公什么话都没有说的话，这个妇人所许的愿就要成立。
So a father and a husband can step in to intercede for the wife and the daughter.
所以一位父亲或是一位丈夫，他可以介入，让这个女儿或妻子的话能够不成立。
There is an exception, though.
但是还有一个例外的情况。
Numbers 39, the next verse. Also, any vow of a widow or a divorced woman by which she has bound herself shall stand against her.
民数记的33:9，寡妇或被休了妇人所许的愿，她所有约束自己的话都是有效的。
If a woman is on her own, no dad, no husband, then any vow she makes will stand and not be released.
所以一个女子如果她没有父亲也没有丈夫的话，她所说的这些承诺都要实现。
You know, I think Pastor Michelle is going to be going out soon, and
It's okay.
So, all right, we're going to continue to pray for him. So, what happens if the husband is trying, would try to void the commitment after, you know, the commitment the wife makes after that first day? Oh, what happens if the husband tries to avoid the commitment after the first day? That she made the commitment.
如果这个妇女她已经说出她的承诺的话的话，那这个她的丈夫要如何来那个把她这个免除掉呢？
So we go to the Bible, Numbers 30:15. But if he does not make them void after he has heard them, then he shall bear her guilt.
在这个丈夫他有责任要承担，在民数记的30:15。但她丈夫听了这个话，不是在当天就否决了，是隔天以后再废了这些话的话，这个丈夫就要担当这个妇人的罪孽。The
hubby is responsible to fulfill any financial and judicial obligations.
所以她没有在当天否决这个太太所许的愿，所以太太的所有的责任，包括财务上的责任，包括这个所有的法律上面的责任，都要由丈夫来承担。
He takes her place, and with all the debt and all the obligations, he needs to take care of all of that and pay it off himself.
他妻子所做的承诺以及所有的这些财务上面的这些负债的话，丈夫就要站在取代妻子的角色上帮他来成全。
It does not seem fair, does it?
听起来好像不太公平，对不对？
A man needs to keep his word.
但是男人必须要遵守诺言。
But the woman has some loopholes according to Numbers.
但妇女好像有一些漏洞可以钻。
Her dad and her husband can step up to help her out.
她的丈夫或她的父亲可以站出来来帮助女儿或她的妻子。
But there's something very exciting happening here.
但是这里有很非常令人振奋的东西在发生。
You know, and Brian said this earlier, for the past 3 decades or so, I've been doing marriage and pre-marriage counseling, including marriage seminars.
牧师有30多年这婚姻跟婚前辅导的经验。
You know, I always tell the bride and the groom to be cognizant of a scientific study that was done decades ago.
根据这个过去做的这些科学的实验的话，那我们会发现男生跟女生讲话的内容不太一样。So
men, on the average, speaks 20,000 words a day.
男人啊，一天大概讲20,000字的话。
But women, on the average, speaks 40,000 words a day.
但女生呢，一天可能讲四万字的话。
So what usually happens is, men, the men always use up their 20,000 words at work.
所以男人呢，可能在外面工作的话，一天两万字已经在场工作场上讲完了。
Well, the woman still has a lot of words left when he comes home.
所以当先生回到家里的话，他的太太可能还有好多话要讲。
So there's some reasoning for the rash utterances for the women.And this is where it gets exciting.
所以因为女人还有很多的话要讲，所以难免会有一些冒失的话冒出来。
Because we all always say that the books in the Old Testament always points to Jesus. In fact, the whole Bible points to Jesus.
我们知道旧约都指向我们的主耶稣基督，整本圣经都是指向耶稣基督。
And then the Old Testament points to the New, and the New explains the Old.
旧约指向新约，那新约解释旧约。
You see, the New Testament tells us that we as Christians are the bride of Christ.
新约告诉我们都是耶稣基督的新娘。
And Jesus, He is our husband.
耶稣基督是我们每个人的丈夫。
Jesus lived on this earth without any sin.
耶稣基督在世上没有犯过任何罪。
He kept His word.
他遵守他的诺言。
We are to keep our words also, our promises to Him and to others.
但是我们要遵照我们对神的应许，对人的这些应许，不是吗？
But we, as the bride of Christ, have rash utterances.
但是身为神的新娘，我们常常讲一些冒失的话。
We speak at times rashly, do things rashly.
我们讲话冒失，行事也鲁莽。
You know, sometimes we make promises to God.To others, and we get in trouble.
知道我们有时候向神许愿，向人承诺，但是我们碰到麻烦。
We have too many words and say things and promise things that we should not have.
我们讲了太多冒失的话，做一些我们不应该做的事情。
But we have a husband who can intercede for us and a heavenly Father who loves us.
耶稣基督是我们的新郎，是我们的丈夫，所以他可以为我们的代求。我们的天父也可以为我们代求。
We are the bride of Christ, and Jesus is our husband.
我们是耶稣基督的新娘，耶稣基督是我们的新郎。
Every Christian is Jesus's bride.
每位基督徒都是耶稣的新娘。
You see, our husband, he knows what we have to go through here on earth.
我们的丈夫耶稣基督，他知道我们在人生上面所度过的一切。
Hebrews 4:15-16 For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Verse 16 Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy, find grace to help in time of need.
希伯来书的4:15-16因我们的大祭司耶稣并非不能体恤我们的软弱，他曾凡事受过试探，跟我们一样，只是他没有犯罪，所以我们只管坦然无惧地来到施恩的宝座前，为要得连续蒙恩惠，做随时的帮助。
Not only does Jesus been through life here on earth, even more than any one of us, yet without sin, He is still making intercession for us as our husband.Hebrews 7:25 Therefore, He is also able to save to the uttermost those who come to God through Him, since He always lives to make intercession for them.
耶稣基督在世3.5年的时间，但他所承受的一切是远超过我们这些凡人所能够承受的。但是呢，他没有犯罪，所以在希伯来书的7:25，凡靠着他进到神面前的人，他都能拯救到底，因为他是长远活着替他们代求。
We have a husband who will intercede for us.
信主的人有位丈夫耶稣基督，他为我们代求，他会介入我们。
He is not just doing this in heaven, but also here now for all Christians. Romans 8:26.Likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
他不只在天上为王，他差派圣灵住在我们里面。罗马书的8:26，况且我们的软弱有圣灵帮助。我们本不晓得应当怎么祷告，但圣灵亲自用说不出来的叹息。
We at times fail. We don't know what to do, but we have a Heavenly Father who loves us. We have the Son of God, our husband who's interceding for us, and we have the Holy Spirit who groans when we are lost, when we don't know how to pray, also interceding for us.
我们在世上是经常跌倒的，我们灵命的历程常常挫败的，但是我有一位天父他在看顾我们，我们有位丈夫耶稣基督在为我们代求，我们有圣灵在照顾我们，让我们无法说出的祷告都能够呈现出来。
What an amazing God that we have.
这位三位一体的神何等的奇妙。
Let's close with what happened to Peter.
我们来看看彼得的下场，做我们的结论。
Hours before Jesus was about to be crucified, Peter made some bold, rash promises to Jesus.
就在耶稣要被卖手上十字架之前不久，彼得做了一个很大胆的说法。
You see, but Jesus, he knew already what was going to happen.
但是耶稣早就知道这一切。
Peter, you are going to deny me.
彼得啊，你要否认我。
No way, Lord, I will never deny you.
彼得说，绝不可能，我绝对不会否认你的。
Even if all these people deny you, pointing to the other disciples, I'm willing to die for you.
彼得指着其他的门徒，即使他们都要背弃你，我要为你而死啊。
Jesus then stepped in, Luke 22:31-32, and the Lord said, Simon, Simon, indeed Satan has asked for you, that he may sift you as wheat. Verse 32, but I have prayed for you.That your faith should not fail, and when you have returned to me, strengthen your brethren.
路加福音的22:31-32，主又说：“西门，西门，撒旦想要得着你们，好像筛你们，像筛麦子一样。但我已经为你祈求，叫你不至于失了信心。你回头以后，要坚固你的弟兄。”
You know, Jesus knew Peter very, very well, and Jesus used Peter's original name, Simon, which means Shifting sand.
耶稣非常非常了解彼得。那西门原来的意思是筛的意思。
You know, he was telling Peter, Satan is coming after you.
他在跟彼得说，撒旦要得着你啊。
To sift you like wheat,
好像筛麦子一样。
But I'm praying for you. I'm interceding for you.
但是我为你祷告，我为你代求。
That your faith should not fail.
让你的信心不至于失败。
But when you come back to me, when you make it through the shifting, strengthen and encourage your brethren.
但是你在经过这个筛麦子的过程，在否认主后，就是悔改以后，你要回头坚固你的弟兄。
Peter was boasting. You can count on me, Jesus.
彼得很大胆地向耶稣说，你可以信任我。
Jesus said.I know you, Peter. I know you, Simon Peter.
耶稣对彼得说：“彼得，我太了解你，我知道你的西门这个筛子这个意思。”
I'm praying for you.
我在为你祷告。
A few hours later, Jesus was being tried by the high priest.
在几个小时后，耶稣被大祭司审判。
And Peter denied Jesus three times.
彼得就在院子里面否认耶稣三次。
And then at that time, Jesus and Peter's eyes met as Jesus was being led out.
当耶稣被带出去的时候，他们彼得跟耶稣四目相望。
Peter then went out and wept, cried bitterly.
彼得走到外面痛哭流涕懊悔。
Why?
为什么？
The eyes of Jesus on Peter were eyes of compassion.
耶稣在看着彼得的眼神是充满怜悯。
Jesus already knew that this would happen.
耶稣早就知道这件事情会发生。
Jesus died, buried, 3 days later, resurrected.
耶稣基督被钉十字架，三天后死了复活。
Jesus did a lot after the resurrection, but he made a special appearance.To Peter.
在复活的时间，耶稣做了很多的事情，但耶稣特别找彼得跟他见面。
Jesus said to Peter three times in front of the fire cooking the fish, Peter, do you love me?
在这个早上在煮这个鱼当早餐的时候，耶稣去找彼得，问彼得说：“彼得，你爱我吗？”
I like you, Jesus. Then Jesus said, "Feed my lambs."
彼得对耶稣说：“主啊，我爱你。”耶稣就叫彼得喂养我的小羊。
Peter, do you love me?
耶稣在问彼得：“你爱我吗？”
I really like you a lot. He couldn't even say he loved him because of what he had done. He was so ashamed.
彼得是为着自己所否认主的事情深深的懊悔，但是彼得说：“主啊，我爱你。”
But Jesus said, "Tend my sheep."
耶稣说：“彼得，你喂养我的羊。”
Peter, do you love me?
耶稣再问：“彼得，你真的爱我？”
Lord, you know all things. You know I love you.
彼得说：“主啊，你知道万事，你知道我爱你。”
Peter, feed my sheep.
彼得，喂养我的羊。
Jesus was saying to Peter, I knew this would happen, Peter. I told you I would pray for you, intercede for you.
耶稣在跟彼得说，我知道你会三次否认我，但是我为你代求。
I'm restoring you to go and do what I called you to do.
我要恢复你，我要兼顾你的心情，然后回到你起初的呼召。
I'm not condemning you, Peter. I'm your intercessor.
彼得，我没有谴责你，我在为你代求。
Peter's sin was forgiven by God.
彼得的罪被神赦免了。Should
we forgive others?
难道我们应该饶恕其他人吗？
A few days later, preaching on the Pentecost Sunday, Peter was just sharing God's word. 3,000 responded, 3,000 saved.
在五旬节的当日的早晨，彼得就讲了一篇道，然后当天有三千个人信而受洗。
Jesus stepped up and stepped into Peter's life and saw Peter, led Peter through all the trials.
耶稣介入到彼得的生活里面，然后带领他经过所有的这些信仰上面的挑战。
You have a friend in Jesus Christ.
所以我们在耶稣，耶稣是我们的至好。
You have a husband who knows you, who will be protecting you, who is praying for you.
耶稣基督是我们的丈夫，他会为我们代求，会来保护我们。
If you don't know what to do, know that you have a bridegroom who is praying for you.
当你们是不知道该怎么办的时候，你知道我们的耶稣，我们的新郎在为我们祷告。
If you are willing to do God's will, Jesus is your bridegroom, even if you mess up.
如果我们把主当作是我们的新郎，即使我们跌倒，即使我们失败了，耶稣基督一样在保护代求。
You need to be willing to do God's will, and He will step up for you into you.
我们要照着主的心意而行啊！耶稣基督会保护我们，为我们代求。
The Lord is making intercession for you. For me, right now,
就在这个时候，我们的主就在为你我代求。We
are the bride of Christ.
我们是耶稣基督的新娘，不是吗？
We have a bridegroom who will always be there for us.
我们的新郎耶稣基督永远跟我们在一起。Jesus
is praying.
耶稣在为我们祷告。Making
intercession to the Father for us.
我们知道耶稣在父天父的面前在为我们代求。Jesus
is our covering, our bridegroom.
耶稣基督是我们的遮盖，他是我们的新郎。He
is the perfect one.
他是那个完美无缺。Even
when we make mistakes in the family, make mistakes at work, make mistakes in church, we have the Son of God who's making intercession for us.
即使在我们的家庭里面，在我们的职场里面，在我们的教会里面，我们犯了错事的讲，耶稣基督在为我们代求。When
we read Numbers 30, we see that man must keep his word.
在看民数记30章的时候，我们知道人必须要来信守承诺。
But her words will be made void when the father or the bridegroom steps up and protects the woman.
当一个人他所许的愿、所约束自己的话太过冒失、无法实现的话，他的父亲、他的丈夫会介入。
We are the bride of Christ.
我们是耶稣基督的新娘。
There's one exception though.
那有个例外。
If the woman detaches herself from her husband, from her father, she will be responsible for all her words.
所以一个守寡的或是一个离婚的妇人，她所讲的话，她必须自我约束。
No one will help her.
没有人会帮助她。
You'll be responsible for all your words, all your actions, if you decide to detach yourself from Jesus and choose not to follow His commandments.
当我们远离了耶稣基督，拒绝了耶稣基督，然后不遵照耶稣的话语而行的时候，我们就必须自己承担。
John 8:31, then Jesus said to those Jews who believe Him, if you abide in my word, you are my disciples indeed.
约翰福音的8:31，耶稣对信他的犹太人说：“你们若常常遵守我的道，真是我的门徒。”
1 John 2:4, He who says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him.
约翰一书的二章四节，人若说我认识他，却不是遵守神的诫命，便是说谎话的，真理也不在他心里。
Every person needs to come to the place to admit that I need help.
每个人都需要来到一个这个转捩点，我需要帮助啊。
I can't do life on my own.
我实在没有办法再靠自己了。
Don't be detached from Jesus.
要跟我们的主耶稣基督分离啊。
Jesus is making intercession for you.
我们的主耶稣基督在为我们代求。
Turn to him now.
让我们现在就转向我们的主。
Repent.
懊悔忏悔。
Be his bride.
成为他的新娘。
Our bridegroom will keep his word.
我们的耶稣基督，我们的新郎会遵照他的诺言。
He really, really loves you.
他是真心的爱着我们。
And we should be very thankful.
我们应该充满感恩的心。
Let's pray.
我们先来祷告。
Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父
，We again thank you for your word.
再次为你的话语献上感谢。
You are an amazing God.
你真的是一位令人惊叹的神。
We're thankful for the bridegroom in Jesus.
我们真的是为我们是耶稣的新娘献上感谢。
And I pray everyone here, Lord, will know Jesus as Lord and Savior and be Jesus' bride.
我们为着在场的弟兄姐妹来祷告，让他们都能够接受你是他们的主跟救主，以及接受你是我们的新郎。
Pray in the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
Amen. Let's we're gonna have communion right away. If you are a Christian, you feel free to join us in remembering what Jesus has done for us. And but if you're not a Christian, then you join us only if you're a Christian.
我们来举行圣餐。如果是你是已经接受耶稣基督成为你的救主跟救主的话，可以一起来享用。如果你还没有接受耶稣基督成为你的主跟救主的话，我们祷告，希望你也能够接受他。
You know that night before Jesus was arrested, Jesus was at this meal with his disciples, and they were very, very sad. They're wondering what's going to happen. But in the middle of the meal.Jesus took the bread and broke it, and he said, "Do this in remembrance of me, and we're gonna partake together."
在耶稣基督被卖的那一晚，他知道门徒非常的忧伤恐惧，耶稣就举行圣餐，说你们如此行，为的是要来纪念我。
You know, you can almost feel how the disciples felt.Because they don't know the future. But Jesus comforted them by taking the bread, breaking it. And you know, we know that Jesus is the bread of life.
门徒们根本不晓得未来会发生什么事情，不晓得前途茫茫。但是耶稣举起饼来，说这是我的身体为你们舍的，你们如此行是为了纪念我。
After the meal, he took the cup and he said, "This cup is in the new covenant in my blood, and we're going to partake together to remember Jesus shed his blood for our sins."
然后耶稣举起杯来说，这杯是用我所流的血所立的新约，你们如此行是为了来纪念我。保险能够洗净人的罪。
Our Jesus really loves you.
我们的耶稣真的是爱着我们每一个人。
And we do this in remembrance of Him.
我们如此行是来纪念我们的主。
After the meal, Jesus took the cup and said, "This cup is in a new covenant in my blood." And we do this in remembrance of Him. Let's partake together. Let's stand for the closing song. It is our prayer that you would bless each one here, that everyone here will know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Bless your people, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.